Hi everyone and welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going over the origin, insertion and action of the psoas major muscle.
Pictured here we can see the psoas major muscle in isolation. And the psoas major is one of the three muscles which make up the iliopsoas muscle. And the next is the iliacus muscle, which you can see I brought in here, and is filling the superior two-thirds of the iliac fossa and coming down and sharing an insertion point here with the psoas major muscle on the lesser trochanter of the femur. And now I brought in the last muscle of the iliopsoas, which is the psoas minor. You can see coming down here, and the psoas minor actually connects onto the hip, so it's not sharing that insertion point with the iliacus and the psoas major muscle. And I think this is why some internet sources on the subject haven't included the psoas minor as part of the iliopsoas muscle group. But when I've gone and looked at the peer-reviewed research and published literature on the subject, as well as textbooks, the vast majority of them seem to include the psoas minor as one of the muscles of the iliopsoas muscle group. Therefore, for this video, I'm going to include it as part of this muscle group as well. And now you can see I brought in the inguinal ligament here, and the inguinal ligament is connecting to the anterior superior iliac spine and coming down and then connecting onto the pubic tubercle. Now, one thing to note about the inguinal ligament is that both the iliacus and the psoas major muscle are passing underneath this inguinal ligament. So both these muscles are deep to the inguinal ligament. So let's take a look at the origin, and you can see I've marked it out here in red. You can see I've also labelled the vertebrae L1 to L5, so that'd be lumbar vertebrae, and then T12 would be the last of the thoracic vertebrae. And you'll notice these little projections right here, these little bony bits that are sticking out. They're the transverse processes. So it's originating on the transverse processes of L1 all the way down to L5. It's also originating on the vertebral bodies of T12 all the way down to L5. And it's also originating on these intervertebral discs that are in between each of the vertebrae here as well. So let's take a look at the insertion next. And you can see I've marked that out here in blue either side, and that's going to be on the lesser trochanter of the femur. And both the iliacus and the psoas major are both going to share this insertion point. And you'll remember both of those are muscles of the iliopsoas muscle group, as well as the psoas minor as well. And the psoas major and the iliacus are going to come down this area here, and as the muscles come down, they're going to merge together and then form that common tendon that connects onto the lesser trochanter of the femur.
So let's take a look at the actions next. And if you've done a bit of research about this muscle prior to watching this video, you might have noticed the conflict of information about the actions for this muscle. You look at one source and it has one group of actions, and you go and look at another source and it might not mention some of those actions there. And that can be a bit frustrating when you just want to know what the muscle does. The reason for this is when you go and look at the research journals and the bare bones literature published about this muscle, there's a bit of a conflict of information there, in the sense that there's been a bit of a debate amongst academics for a little while about the actions of this muscle. But I've gone through and I've read all that, you know, all the different research papers that I could find. I've looked at the most up-to-date and the most recent research journals to try and condense all this information down into the video, save you having to go out and look at that all that yourself. So we'll look at the first and the most primary action of the psoas major. That's going to be flexion of the hip joint, and that's when the femur just comes up like that. But flexion of the hip joint can also occur if I keep both my legs planted firmly on the floor and I just hinge at the hips and lean forward. Then again, that would be flexion of the hip joint too, and it's the psoas major which can be a contributor in that movement. Now, another action which the psoas major can assist in is lateral flexion of the trunk, which would be just like that. And that will only occur when just one side of the psoas major contracts. But bear in mind, it's not in a very advantageous position to cause this lateral flexion of the trunk, It's connecting onto the vertebrae and coming down to the femur. So it's going to provide really weak assistance in this movement compared to other muscles like the obliques, which are just obviously right here, which are going to be in a much more advantageous position to cause the movement of lateral flexion. Now, another movement which it can assist in very weakly would be external rotation of the femur. So you can see the femur is internally rotated at the moment. As it rotates outwards, that would be external rotation. And there's been a bit of a debate about the rotation ability of the psoas major muscle. It seems external rotation is one which it can very weakly assist in. Another one that's been suggested though is internal rotation. And also another one which was suggested was adduction, bringing the femur back towards the midline of the body. Now those two actions there, the majority of papers which I've read, I couldn't really find very much data to support that. The majority of papers were in favor of those first three actions which I mentioned there, rather than internal rotation and adduction. Now, one thing I did note in some of these papers, it did say that the psoas major plays a dynamic stability role. So what that means is it can stabilize the femur here in the acetabulum, just makes sure it stays stable during movements such as adduction or during internal rotation. So, you know, the psoas major will be switched on, if you like, when during those movements, but not necessarily because it's actively contributing to them, but more just because it's providing that stability to the femur during those movements. Now, of course, the psoas major muscle is one of the iliopsoas muscle group muscles. You've also got the psoas minor and the iliacus, and I've made videos on both of them. I'll put them in the description box below, so check that out if you're interested in watching either of those two videos. And if you've enjoyed this video, or you found it helpful, you know which buttons to press. Press that like, subscribe, leave a comment, let me know what you thought. Thanks again for watching, everyone. See you all next time.